The ocean is full of mysteries and wonders, and is home to thousands of species of marine life. In this presentation, we examine the killer whale, a species that has quite the reputation for being the top apex predator. Our focus is on the variety of ecotypes of this species and the specific habitats and diets of each. The killer whale is a marine mammal and the largest species in the dolphin family. They can live up to 80 years, grow up to 8 meters, and weigh up to 5 tons. Being the apex predator, they are by far the most feared marine mammal to roam the ocean waters. They hunt in packs, earning them the nickname Wolves of the Sea. There happen to be several different subspecies of killer whales that live in different geographical areas, and although they physically resemble each other at first glance, there are numerous differences between the groups that we will describe here. First, we present the basic characteristics shared by all the killer whale subspecies. Orcas communicate or identify one another through a form of sonar and echolocation. These animals rarely drift apart for protection, so each pod has its own sound. To be able to identify a member of the pod, orcas generate a specific pattern of whistles and clicking noises by blowing air through their air sacs, which create sounds that bounce off things to help in the water. Not only does echolocation help an orca find its pod, but it also helps to find food and to navigate. You would think the orca's biggest weapon would be its teeth or its tail, but surprisingly enough, it's actually their brain, which is the second largest among all marine mammals. This puts them at an advantage when it comes to hunting, which involves close communication to plan and execute coordinated attacks on their prey. Orcas use a variety of methods when catching their prey, including herding fish, drowning other whales, and propelling themselves up onto beaches. They use a karate chop technique to stun sharks, using their tail to slam into their head. Their diet consists of marine mammals, sharks, seals, octopus, fish, crustaceans, turtles, and more. Since they are such strategic hunters, it takes the orca significantly longer to find prey than it does to capture it. The Northern Hemisphere orcas are grouped into ecotypes. Ecotypes meaning a distinct form or race of a plant or animal species occupying a particular habitat. The name of these ecotypes are resident, bigs, offshore, and North Atlantic types 1 and 2. Each of these groups has specific habitats and diets. Resident orcas are known for traits like belly rubbing or having a family-centered hierarchy. They live on both coasts of the North Pacific Ocean. Their diets consist mainly of salmon, but populations in Alaska eat all types of fish. Residents stay with their family groups and travel in a community pod. One distinct feature of this ecotype is that their offspring live with their mother for their entire lives. Unfortunately, the species has become endangered due to diminishing salmon populations and pollution. In 2009, a study showed there were less than 80 individuals left in the wild. Next are the transients, or bigs. They are also reside in the North Pacific, but are found more northwest. They prey on harbor seals, harbor porpoises, California sea lions, and other animals like calves of gray whales. It is said that they like to travel in small groups, which is odd for orcas. Like residents, they are known to have a hierarchy pod structure. Even though they are very similar in appearance to resident orcas, these two types of ecotypes do not breed or communicate with each other. The next type of orca is the offshore form. It is found offshore from California to the Bering Sea, typically seen over the continental shelf. Physically, they are the smallest of the Northern Hemisphere orcas and are most closely related to the resident orcas. Their food preference is unknown, but it's believed that sharks are a part of their diet since their teeth tend to be worn down. Lastly are the Atlantic types 1 and 2. Type 1 is smaller, and these whales eat whatever they can find, but they prefer mackerel and herring. Some in Norway are known to eat seals. Type 2 is larger, and these prefer to feed on other whales and dolphins. They have long, sharp teeth for digging and ripping into the flesh. A distinctive feature of this ecotype are the saddle patches behind the dorsal fin. Both of these groups are threatened by pollution and human activities. Southern Hemisphere orca whales live in the Antarctic region. There are four types: A, B, C, and D. Each exhibits slight variations in appearance. Their diets consist mainly of seals, minke whales, and penguins. Due to algae called diatoms that grow profusely in polar waters, the skin of some of these ecotypes often display a yellowish tone. Type A orcas prefer the open ocean in southern waters, typically between latitudes 40 to 60 south, but they migrate to coastal Antarctic waters to hunt minke whales. They can grow to be humongous marine mammals, up to 31 feet or 9.5 meters in length. Type B orcas are sighted on the Antarctic Peninsula and are considered ice pack whales. This means that they prey on animals resting on ice floes. They use a technique called the wash wave, where they swim rapidly towards an ice floe, which creates a large wave that forces their victim into the ocean. They have been seen eating penguins and seals, but other prey species are unknown. Type C is unique because it is the smallest of the ecotypes. The eye patch is dramatically slanted, and their cape, the skin overlapping the head region going towards the dorsal fin, is much darker than the rest of its body. They have thick ice packs, and their diet includes toothfish, but other diet items are unknown. Finally, the Type D orca is the most elusive of all the southern ecotypes. In 1955, off the coast of New Zealand, scientists found these mammals in a mass stranding, and the next time that any individuals were seen again was in 2019. They have a more rounded head, shorter dorsal fin, and a smaller eye patch. Very little is known about the social structure of this group, because it lives in the stormiest part of the Southern Ocean, which makes observation of this ecotype very difficult. After many years of research, scientists have learned much about orcas, their habitats, ecosystems, and way of life. Yet there's still much more we can learn. These are animals with intelligence and grace, and the difference between the various ecotypes in terms of communication, behaviors, social structures, and diets continue to surprise scientists every day.